From the NASA engineers to the grocery store in our neighborhood, it is a topic that everyone talks about and somehow has an idea. After some people, it will change the world. And after some, it will be the end of us all. Elon Musk and the already deceased Stephen Hawking are among those who believe that we will all come to an end. But I will try to explain artificial intelligence in its simplest form without going into conspiracy theories, no matter how hard I have to hold back. This is supposed to be the purpose of this channel. To explain such complex concepts to someone who has no idea. At the end of this video, you will be able to explain artificial intelligence to your parents or friends who have nothing to do with this topic. So let's not waste time. Let's start with the definition of artificial intelligence. Of course, it is not a dictionary definition. The definition for me is that artificial intelligence is the technology that allows computers to perform tasks that normally require human intelligence. So let us leave that definition for now. But before we go into the depths and examples, let's talk about it a little further. Artificial intelligence and machine learning are terms that are used together. If you remember the previous video in the series on machine learning, we went into detail there. But I have to say something that I mentioned there already. We said that computers can't work that way right now. We said that they can't even go from here to there. Artificial intelligence is a technology sworn to change that. If we look at ourselves, we can actually understand what artificial intelligence is trying to do. Imagine what our brain can do. I'm not talking about absurd things. For example, when you walk at night, you see the outline of something. It has a tail, four legs, normal dog size, and walks like a dog. To understand that this is a dog, you use your senses. You go closer. Because of your existing knowledge, you only need seconds to identify it as a dog. You won't even notice it. Look at these examples, and you understand how you perceive colors, whether you can trust a person, etc. Imagine a system that does this all automatically. You come to the conclusion, make connections, come to the conclusion without any input. Find and solve problems. This is artificial intelligence. But let's go through the examples. Then let's look at what awaits us in the future, what possibilities there are, and where the end of this work will lead us. Let's take a quick look at the video. Looks funny, doesn't it? Maybe you see an idiot running funny, but this is the future. This is an artificial intelligence algorithm created by the Google DeepMind project. The most noticeable thing is this. Engineers told this character to only move from point A to B. Walk, jump, balance. Everything he learned by himself. And sometimes he falls down. He will learn from them. It learns what an obstacle is, what to do when it appears, how fast to run and what position to jump to. It learns from mistakes and produces solutions and applies them, without command. Welcome to the future! There were also some who have heard of this Google DeepMind before, with the name AlphaGo, an artificial intelligence that puts all chess masters in the shade. Here's an example of an artificial intelligence. They just put the rules of chess into the algorithm. He learned where and what move he was going to make, but our character might disappoint you. Because when it comes to AI, Westworld comes in. If you have seen it, you will know what I mean. But I said it in the machine learning video. I said that computers are in the embryonic age. There are signs that he started to crawl. Those who have children know how important it is to crawl. This is the beginning of everything. Then he begins to explore the world. Walking doesn't take long, however. Another example is Nvidia. Graphics cards come to mind when we say Nvidia, right? I'm going to tell you about a little known work of Nvidia, with the driverless car chipset. It revolutionized the entire autonomous driving field. Tesla, Mercedes, or General Motors also work in this field. The best known example is Tesla. It drives by itself. In fact, it is not possible to do so without the data made available to it. So, what is this traffic sign? Where are the road lines? What is the distance? Engineers provide them all as input for autonomous driving in Tesla. Of course, machine learning is reused, but at present, Tesla tools cannot learn from mistakes. But on the platform developed by Nvidia, there is no input. The engineers have not made any input to this algorithm. This algorithm learns to drive independently after a real driver, as if he learned it himself. There is still a long way to go. But in the current tests, he manages to provide an enormously secure drive with fewer errors than a normal driver, an algorithm that learns to drive by itself. As I said, this is also a chipset. In other words, all car brands can apply this algorithm to their vehicles. This is another example of an AI, but I'm going to talk to you about one example of AI that really shocked me. In 2015, a group of scientists at Mount Sinai Hospital in New York decided to integrate the machine learning algorithm into their patient files. These patients' files contained information such as tests, results, and how often they came to the hospital. This algorithm, called Deep Patient, begins learning by analyzing the data of almost 700,000 people, just by looking at the data. In other words, without medical algorithm, that means, what should I know? What is the cause of the disease? This algorithm solves the connection that nobody can see in these patient files and learns what causes the disease and what symptoms indicate which diseases. It also tells you who might have lung cancer. In other words, there were classical methods that could reach a conclusion by looking at the patient record. But Joey Dudley, the head of the research group, says, "This program has an accuracy rate that we have never seen before." But it doesn't stop there. Cancer and so on, it may seem normal to detect such diseases. Some symptoms may already indicate it, but the program has a very strange accuracy in predicting who will suffer from psychiatric conditions like schizophrenia. This is the aspect where things get complicated. No one expected such a result at the beginning of the project. These diseases are very difficult to diagnose even under normal circumstances. But how did it happen? How did he come to these conclusions? Where did he learn this? Welcome to the conspiracy theories about artificial intelligence. I couldn't hold back here. But let's not say conspiracy theories. Let's say probabilities, because it sounds more scientific. Now let's look at both the biggest advantage and the biggest problem of AI. The biggest advantage is this. After you write a learning algorithm, you can use it in many different areas. Think very simply. Imagine you learn to lift a ball from the ground. Do you have to learn to lift a coffee table from the floor? No. Now you know how to lift something off the floor. That's the logic here. Artificial intelligence algorithms can be transferred. It can be used in jobs that you can't even imagine in many other files. But here's the problem. A lot of things you may not have imagined. The algorithm found that patients may have schizophrenia. Those who wrote the algorithm and those who conducted the study did not understand what it was like. And they can't understand because we can't control what and how he learned after a point. If you look at a group of data, we can find multiple connections, but these algorithms can process billions of data in seconds and find very strange connections. Did that function remind you of something? Yes, the human brain. We couldn't understand the human brain either. Here's the same logic. When you talk about artificial intelligence, you also hear the term neural network. These algorithms create a network similar to the neural network in the brain. And what's going on there is now completely out of control. What are we waiting for? Or what's gonna happen? AI will reach its most advanced form. For example, IoT or Internet of Things. Maybe the topic of the next video? Anyway, AI has even more possibilities and needs more data. Features like AI make our lives easier. Or it decides when to turn the lights on and off in smart homes because there's not much room to receive data. There is a lot of data, but it is not enough. Until next time. Bye!